जय हिंद स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे लेक्चर इज लेक्चर नंबर 3 फॉर द क्लास 9th एंड द चैप्टर इज नंबर सिस्टम. नाउ स्टूडेंट्स, इन द लास्ट लेक्चर वी हैव डिस्कस्ड द एक्सरसाइज 1.1 एंड 1.2 ऑफ योर एनसीईआरटी बुक, एंड इन टुडेज लेक्चर वील डिस्कस द एक्सरसाइज नंबर 3 इन विच यू हैव टू टेल the rational numbers or irrational number, terminating decimal, non-terminating decimal, as we have discussed in the last lecture. So student, open your NCERT book and the exercise 1.3, and we'll discuss the question step by step. So let us start with question number 1. You have to write the following in the decimal form and say what kind of the decimal expansion it will have. So question number 1, you see in your book, you have to first of all convert this into decimal form. You know how to convert the fraction to decimal. If the number is being divided by 10 or 100, you can directly convert into decimal. That is 36/100, it will be equal to 3.6, which is a terminating decimal, You can divide it directly. Now let us take the second part, that is 1 divided by 11. You know how to divide it, 0.0, you are not able to divide it, again put 0 and 1 0 here, so it will be 11 9s are 99, and you are again getting 1. Now you put you can put 10 here, but you are unable to divide it. You put 10 here and put 10 here, and again you are dividing it with 9, that is 99, that is again remainder 1. It means you will get 09 09 09 repeatedly. That is, the decimal expansion for this is how much? 0.0 bar, which means that it is non-terminating repeating decimal. It is non-terminating repeating decimal. Okay. So this is the first and second part of question number 1. Let us take this third part, 4 1/8. You know how to convert into decimal. First, this is a mixed fraction. First of all, convert into the improper fraction. You know how to convert into improper fraction. 8 multiplied by 4, that is 32, plus numerator, that is 1. That is, it will be equal to 33/8. And now convert into decimal. So 33 divided by 8, so it will be 4s are 32 10, divided it 0.0 here, 1s are 8, that is 2, you can put 0, 2s are 16, remainder 4, again 0, 5s are 40. So it means it is a terminating decimal, which is 4.125. So it is a terminating decimal. So like this, you divide the fractions or the rational numbers into decimal and tell what type of the solution or decimal this rational number have. So let us take the next part, 3/13. So again, divide 3/13. You know how to divide 3/13. Divide it. It will be, you are not able to divide 3/13. So put point here and 0 here. So it will be 13 2s are 26, and the remainder is 4. Again 0. Again divide. 3s are 39, again 10, you are unable to divide it, put it 0 here, put it 0 here, and 13, how many times? 13 sevens are. It will be equal to 91. Again, it is 90. How many times? 6 times. That is 78. That is 1, 2. Again, you can put 0. And 13 nines are 117. Again, 3 and remainder 3 only. You can put 0 here. 2s are 26. Again, 4, 0. Like this. 3s are 39. Again, 1. And so on. It means you are getting again 1, 0. That is, put 1, 0 here. Again, you can put, it will be 7s are. Means it is repeating after how many times? 2, 3, 0, 7, it is repeating again here. So, it is a non-terminating repeating decimal. So, it is equal to 3 upon 13 is equal to 0.230769 bar. It is non-terminating repeating decimal. Non-terminating repeating decimal it is. 3 upon 13. Like this. So you know how to divide it? So like this you can find 2 upon 11, 329 upon 400 and tell what type of the solution it will have. Terminating or non-terminating, repeating or non-terminating, non-repeating. Now, question number 2. Read it carefully. You know that 1 upon 7 is 0.142857 bar. Can you predict the decimal 2 upon 7, 3 upon 7, 4 upon 7, 5 upon 7, 6 upon 7 without actually doing the long division? If so, how? Read it carefully. Now, because it is given that 1 upon 7 is 0.142857 bar. It is given. Or you can easily divide 1 by 7 and obtain 0.142857 bar. Now you have to find the value of 2 upon 7, which can you write as 1 in 2 into 1 upon 7. 2 into 1 upon 7 is equal to 2 upon 7. That is, put the value of 1 upon 7, which is 0.142857 bar. It means you have to simply multiply this decimal with 2. That is 14, 11, 17, 5, 8, 2 bar. You have to put the bar here. So without dividing 2 by 7, we can easily find 2 upon 7 as 2 into 1 upon 7. And we know the value of 1 upon 7 as 0.142857 bar. Similarly, for 3 upon 7, you can write 3 into 1 upon 7, which is equal to 3 into value of 1 upon 7 is 0.142857 bar. Multiply with 3. 3 sevens are 21, 2 remainder. 3 fives are 15, that is 17. 3 eights are 24, or 1, 25. 6 or 2, 8, 12, 3 ones are 3 and 1, 4 and 0. And put the bar here like this. And like this, you can easily find the value of 4 upon 7, which is equal to 4 into 1 upon 7. And like this, similarly 5 upon 7, that is 5 into 1 upon 7 like this. You can easily find. So this is the method to find the value of 2 upon 7, 3 upon 7, 4 upon 7, 5 upon 7, 6 upon 7 by using the value of 1 upon 7 which is given. So somewhat easy question it is. Now, question number 4 and question number 3. they are of same type and they are important question. Now in these types of questions, you have to convert non-terminating repeating decimals into rational numbers, because you know that non-terminating repeating decimals are rational numbers, non-terminating repeating and terminating also. So in question number 3 as well as in 4, you have to convert the non-terminating repeating decimal into rational numbers. So what is given in the question number 3? It is given that 0.6 bar, and you have to convert it into a rational number. So how you have to convert into a rational number? Let us take. Let x is equal to 0.6 bar, and 0.6 bar means 6, 6, 6, 6 and so on. Let us call it 1. Now multiply both sides by, multiply both sides by 10. Why I'm multiplying by 10? Now, as many digits have bar on it, multiply by 10 or 100 or 1000. If the digit have, one digit have bar on it, then multiply by 10. If the bar is on two digits, multiply by 100. If the bar is on three digits, multiply by 1000 and so on. Now, because in this question, the bar is only one digit, so I'm multiplying by 10. So multiply this both side by 10, so it will be 10x. Multiply by 10, this, and multiply the right hand side by 10, you will get 6.6666 and so on, like this. If you multiply 0.666666 into 10, you will get 6.6666 and so on, because on multiplication the decimal shifted to the right hand side. If it is multiplied by 10, it is shifted to one place of decimal. If it is multiplied by 100, it is shifted by two places of decimal, and so on. Okay, now subtract first equation from second. So 10x is equal to 6.666 and so on, and the first equation is 0.666 and so on, and subtract. This will be cancelled out. You are getting 6. 10x minus 1x, it will be equal to 9x. X is equal to 6 upon 9, that is 2 upon 3. This is the rational number for this 0.6 bar. This is the method to convert any non-terminating repeating decimal into a rational number. So you can have a quick look on this solution to convert a non-terminating repeating decimal into a rational number. Now second part of this question number, this is the first part of question number 3. This is the first part of question number 3. Now let us take the second part, in which we have somewhat different part in this. So it is 0.47. It will have bar on only one digit and one digit before the bar. So how you have to do it? Now it means that 0.47777 and so on, like this. Now whenever we have a digit before the digit having bar, first of all you have to shift that digit to the left hand side. How many digit we have before the bar? Only one. So multiply by 10 to shift this 4 to the left hand side. So multiply both sides by 10. So it will be 10x is equal to 4.7777 and so on. Let us call it 1. We have shifted 4 to the left hand side. Now how many digit, how many digit the bar is? Only on one digit. So as I already told you in the last question or the last part, multiply by 10. Again you have to multiply by 10. So it will be 100x 47, this one of the seven will be shifted to the left hand side. This seven decimal will shift to the right hand side on multiplication. Now again you have to subtract one from second. That is 100x is equal to 47.777, and it is 10x is equal to how many? 4.777, and so on. Now if you subtract it, all this will be cancelled out. 43, 100x minus 10x, it is 90x, and x will be equal to 43/9, which is the rational number for this given non-terminating, non-terminating repeating decimal. When we have a digit before the bar, you have to first of all shift it to the left hand side by multiplying by 10 or 100 or 1000, depending upon how many digits are there. So this is the second part of question number 3. There is one part more, that is the third part also there. Let us do that also, then you will have a good command on it. Third part of question number 3, we have 0.001 bar on three digits, or you can write like this: 0.001 001 001, and so on. So it means you have to multiply both sides by how many? 1000, because we have bar on three digits. So 1000x, it will be 001. The decimal will shift to the right hand side three places: 001 001, and so on. First and second, same method. Subtract first equation from the second. That is 1000x is equal to 1.001 001, and first equation is 0.001 001, and so on. Subtract it as usual. This will be cancelled out. It is equal to 1. That is 1000x minus 1x, 999x. So x will be equal to 1/999. This is the rational number for this non-terminating repeating decimal. So we have done three questions based on this to convert non-terminating repeating decimal into a rational number. Let us take question number 4 also, because in this also you have to convert the non-terminating repeating decimal into a rational number. That is question number 4. It is 0.9. So let us call it x is equal to 0.9999, in and so on. Let us call it 1. Again multiply by 10 both sides. As usual, it is 10x, 9.9999, and so on. Because if you multiply by 10, the decimal will shift to the one place of decimal to the right hand side, this decimal. So subtract first equation from second as usual. To 10x is equal to 9.9999, x is equal to 0.9999, and so on in both the condition. Subtract it, this will be cancelled out. It will be 9 9x, 10x minus 1x, 9x. So x will be 9/9 equal to 1. Now you wonder why we are getting 0.9999 as equal to 1, because as we go forever for 99.999999, there is no gap between 0.99999 and 1, so therefore it is equal to 1. There is no gap between 0.99999 so on and 1, so therefore it is infinite terminating, therefore it is equal to 1. So that's all for today, and we have done up to question number 4 of the third exercise. You do it, and a good command over these questions. Until the next lecture, Jai Hind.